Gemstones are adored across the globe, and owning one is a real pleasure for many, many people around the world. And one company tapping into this market is Gemfields. Its chief executive is Ian Harebottle and joins us now. Ian, welcome.
Thank you.
You're one of the leading gemstone companies, and in fact, you just scored your first maiden profit. What's your strategy for the market?
Yes, thank you. First of all, we'd like to, we certainly are one of the leading gemstone companies, but if we could hone in more specifically, one of the leading coloured gemstone.
Right.
You know, some of our friends in the diamond sector may challenge that a little bit, but we certainly believe we're up there. Our strategy is focusing on coloured gemstones. We see this as a very unique opportunity. Obviously, everyone understands diamonds. You know, diamonds is well marketed, well promoted. What most people don't realise is that back in, up until the 1940s, global colored gemstone sales was pretty much on par with global diamond sales. Since then, diamond sales have gone ahead and colored gemstone sales have gone behind. This is for various reasons, but one of the main reasons is diamonds have been heavily marketed and promoted, creating an in-depth awareness in the consumer's mind. We see an opportunity to right the balance and to bring colored gemstones back to their rightful position, at least equal with diamonds. And in order to do this, we need to market them, we need to mine them efficiently, and we need to be able to give the distribution support that it needs.
You already have some colored gemstones under your belt. You've made, yes. Or you've got an option, I think, on an acquisition, haven't
Correct.
You, in Mozambique coming up. What is your growth strategy from here?
Well, at the moment, we have some really exciting colored gemstone assets already in the company. Included among those is Car Gem, which we believe is one of the world's greatest emerald deposits, that is in Zambia. We also have Kariba, which is a fantastic amethyst deposit. And as you rightly said, we've just acquired the option to have a 75% stake in a Mozambique ruby deposit. All three of them, in my opinion anyway, some of the greatest gemstone deposits in each of their respective categories. Our focus and our vision is to consolidate, is to keep growing on what we're doing well, but always keeping an eye open for other coloured stone assets. There are numerous coloured stone deposits around the world, but finding great coloured stone assets is not so easy. So we're really looking for great deposits.
How do you see you mentioned Mozambique again there, how do you see that developing? I know you think this is, or you have said this is a relatively small operation, but you've got some big plans, haven't you?
Yeah. It's currently small because we've just started there, but we have some very big plans. It's a very exciting deposit. The Mozambique ruby deposit was only discovered in 2005, so just a very short while ago. Up until now, most of the mining taking place there has been very small scale, most of it illegal, so almost, if I can
right.
say that word, scratchings at night. And yet indications are that a significant value is coming out of the ground, but it's being taken out of the country fairly illegally. If it's illegal mining and it's not regulated or licensed, it's obviously taken out, you know, in an illegal way, and it's not benefiting the country, the economy, or anything else. And we've got some really good partners there, and we're looking to invest quite heavily. And we see over in the short-term future, building that into a really substantial business.
At what sort of cost?
You know, cost is it's going to be relatively small, and the exact cost is going to be only discovered once or understood once we've done the geological work. Over the next year or two, it's probably going to cost us a couple of million dollars, not huge, just to do the basic geological studies, bulk sampling, drilling, etc., etc. But the indications are that even doing the bulk sample, we are going to get production, and that production will almost pay for itself. So it's one of the unique deposits where your basic geology is paid for by the production, and everything after that, your capital investment after that will come, you know, be very easy once you understand, you know, the actual value in the ground and how you're going to sell it. And but we'll come to that at a later stage.
What about the statement you made, 9 month production figures, I think you said this year, you called pleasing. What should investors expect for the full year? What sort of excitements are there for investors?
Well, you know, pleasing, we were obviously, you know, pleasing is maybe quite a soft, we were very pleased, if I could say that. We've come from a situation where Gemfields relisted onto the London stock market in 2008, yes. And just after that, the market collapsed. And the latter part of 2008 and most of 2009, it's all history. We know how markets were really tough and how it affected Gemfields like everyone else. But certainly over the last little while, we've brought our operating costs down at the Car Gem mine. Our operating costs per carat have come down from 90 cents a carat down to around about 50 cents. And our revenue per carat has gone from initially zero, we were unable to sell during 2008 and 9, and our revenue per carat is now over $2. So, you know, that's fairly pleasing. But we still, you know, we believe in this market, we believe in the mines, and we still think there's a long way to go. And that's why I tend to use the word pleasing, because we're always looking for more. coming back to your question, investors can, I think they're going to be, you know, very happy. I think investors are going to be certainly well pleased with our results. The results should be out in the next couple of months, and that'll be the full year results. And we're in a very good, comfortable position, and giving us a strong confidence that we can now start taking on these other projects.
What about the economic backdrop? How does that affect a coloured gemstone company?
Well, you know, it's one of those things where it's good and bad. Obviously, the economy in 2008 and 9 was tough, and that affected all companies. And that's the bad side. You know, it made people really, it was a tough environment to operate. The good side is it forced you to get off, you know, your comfort zone. We were, I think a lot of people in gemstones and luxury goods in general, America was absorbing almost all that we could produce, and then a little bit went to Europe. And we realized that we had to start looking at the East, but it was too profitable and too convenient. With that turmoil, it forced the market to say, hey, let's do something different. And certainly from Gemfields' perspective, right now, probably 60% of our product is being absorbed within the East. That's the Arab states, India and China. And the other 40% now coming to Europe and the States, which is dramatically different to how it was before, but it's much more healthy. And I'm very pleased to say that all of those markets are showing an increasing demand for and appreciation for the products we bring into them.
And you've got a rough emerald auction, I believe, in Correct. Singapore, haven't Yes. you? Coming up at
next week.
Is that fully booked?
Well, it's overbooked. In fact, at the moment, you know, we're very, very cautious. We do something really unique. The way colored gems were sold in the past was literally a mixed bag approach. Miners of colored gemstones would produce some really good product, but a very small percentage, and a whole lot of less, you know, lower quality product. And the methodology was, if I took all my low quality product and I hid one or two good stones in a bag and I try to sell it to you, you would be so blown away by those few good ones that you'd miss all the bad ones and offer me a good price. This is the thinking. Naturally, the average person buying that saw all the bad ones and discounted the good ones by it. What we do is every single stone that we produce, whether it's emeralds or, you know, it's going to be rubies, etc., they're all put into one of 400 different grades. So we've come up with a very scientific grading system. Every stone's consistently going into those grades, and at our auction they're placed at schedules. So if you buy that schedule, you have a high level of confidence that you will end up with 3,000 or 4,000 or 5,000 stones of the same size, shape and quality, color and quality, which gives you confidence for the first time with colored stones to do production runs. As a result of that, we're way oversubscribed as far as people wanting to attend. We have over 100 of the world's leading colored gemstone companies really asking and on our list to attend. We try and limit that to the world's top 25. At the moment, we're achieving the world's top 35. So we've got 35 companies that will be coming and attending, all of them proven track record, with, as I said, another 75 or plus banging on our door, please let us in.
You've been at the company, what, 2 years, I think, haven't
Correct.
You? Your strategy is, of course, now just beginning to kick in properly with the company. Where's the business going to be in a year's time?
Well, it's always difficult to look forward, but I'm quietly confident that we're going to be significantly further ahead than we are now. Really, it's just the power of inertia and momentum. We've grown substantially in the last 2 years. You know, we've more than doubled in size. But I'm expecting exponential growth. So I'm expecting the growth going forward to be even larger in quantum than over the last 2 years.
Wow, exponential growth, sounds good. Let's hope it carries out. Okay, Ian Harebottle, thanks indeed for joining us. So Chief Executives there of Gemfields.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorized by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.